How does an animal know self, as opposed to things that are non-self, and react to all the non-self, but not react with something in our own bodies? Well, to start, let's just talk about immunity. For many years, it was believed an animal can produce an immune response to foreign material, but they'll never produce antibodies to themselves. And anything that was contrary to that was treated with a great deal of skepticism. But let me go back to the beginning. My boss and my mentor, Ernest Witebsky, was interested in the substances that stimulate immune response, the antigens. All of us believed that autoimmunity could not occur. I made the thyroglobulin and was very disappointed to find out that it elicited antibodies. So that was a real puzzle. How could that happen? So I did it again, I got the same result. Then I had the idea, well, let's look at the thyroid gland. If in fact this is a true autoantibody, it should have some effect. It might do some damage to the thyroid gland. We showed these sections to the professor of surgery, and he looked at this and he said, "Oh my God, kid, you have made Hashimoto disease." We were able to get serum samples from patients with Hashimoto disease and do the experiment and show that that disease is the result of true autoimmune response, which damages the thyroid. And now we know that autoimmune diseases, which we used to think of as very rare, are very, very common.
The idea that there is a scientific definition that explains a condition, validates a patient, and validates their experience, and validates their need for treatment, it is truly an empowering thing. If you go back to this Big Bang moment for autoimmune disease, he discovered a body misfunction, if you will, that no one thought could exist. That's mind-boggling. It did take Noel's genius, but it took Dr. Witebsky's mentorship to have him understand the value of pursuing the different course. That unbelievable combination is what's resulted in this burgeoning science and a patient community who's beginning to get its needs met.